Nelson Reposo. Today we're gonna do a really quick review and build upon that manana tomorrow. Hopefully you should be like, yeah, I kinda remember this. Manana. Direct optics. Direct optics. Answer the question who? What was that other question? Who or suppose it starts with a W? What? Why? Who or what? From the verb. They can be either people, insects, or they can be things. People or things. Like Kitty said, direct. Direct object. Get rid of that S. Pronouns. Direct object pronouns can replace nouns. So when we did this 6 weeks ago, we struggled with little tiny sentences like I watch TV. And I said, okay, what's the verb or what's the subject? What's this one have going? I watch TV. The subject. I is the subject. What's the verb? Watched. Oh my gosh. And then we divide a little line and we say, okay, I watch who? No. I watch what? Oh, TV. TV was my direct object. Do you remember how we struggled with this? Oh my gosh. Now, instead of saying I watch TV, you could just replace TV and you could say I watch it. Look at us. You guys are. Yes. Okay, let's look at the next one. Ooh, it has four words in English. You saw the players. What's the subject? Del sujeto. You. What's the verbo? Saw. You saw who? Players. Direct object. If you want to be lazy and not write out los jugadores, because I don't want to write out los jugadores, you can just say you saw them. Alright, so these right here are direct object pronouns. Things like them, him, her, us, it. Moving down here, direct object pronouns. Hopefully we will remember these. We want to say me. In Espanol, it is me. What about you? If you're saying yes, like I help you is te. Him, her, it, or you formal. Lo or la. Yay. Us. Nose. But we said over and over and over that there is a big difference between nos, which means us, and nosotros, which is we. And some of you just try to create your own language and put an N-O-S period, and you're like, oh, that's my abbreviation for nosotros. It isn't. Alright? And then the plural of lo and la was los and las. See, they actually do remember something. Alright, the part we didn't like is the part down here, but hopefully the second time around it should be a little bit easier. These words, the mete, nos, lo, la, whatever it happens to be, come before the conjugated verb in Espanol. So over here, we look at this. She watched the movie. What's my subject? She. What's the verbo? I can't get anything past you people today. She watched who or she watched what? What? A movie is my direct object. And you can say it just like this, and that's fine. Ella miró la película. That's what we've been doing forever. Or you can be flojo or floja, like señora. Instead of saying she watched the movie, she watched it. Now, what's the word for it that I'm going to pick? You have two choices, lo or la. What's it going to be? If it says la película, you should pick la. So, ella la miró. And it goes before the conjugated verb. And we don't like that because that's inverted and flip-flopped to us in English. Aquí, la man read the book. Oh, look, this is the five words in it. What's the subject? El sujeto. Man. What's the verbo?